Today we are installing the new Victron Orion XS into this van. We've got our installers, Morgan and Ira here, and we are going to be swapping out the Orion 12-12-30 that they have in their van for this new and upgraded version with the Explorist Life Retrofit kit that we're gonna have available. And Steph and Morgan are gonna be off to the side taking some notes, making sure we don't need to make any changes to this. Ira is gonna be actually doing the install and I am gonna be narrating through the process. So let's get started. We've disconnected from shore power. We've disconnected power coming from the starter battery. We've turned off solar charging and finally turned off the master disconnect switch. And now just double checking that we don't have any power at our input or output terminals of the old Orion 12-12-30. Now we can disconnect all of the wires going into and out of the Orion and remove them from the unit. And now we can remove the Orion from the wall. And now we can screw the Orion XS to the wall. Now we're going to install a junction stud so all of our negative wires can be combined since this new Orion XS is a non-isolated version. Now we're going to cut the ferrules off of the pre-existing wires that are coming from the Lynx distributor as well as coming from the starter battery and replace those with wire lugs. Next, we have to make a small jumper wire to go from the junction stud we just installed to the ground terminal of the Orion XS to tie all the negatives together. And now we're going to connect all three of those lugs that we just crimped on onto the junction stud we installed earlier. Click. Now it's time to make the connections. So we need to take the strain relief cover off the front of the Orion XS with a very small screwdriver. And now we can loosen up the terminals inside of the Orion XS and connect their respective wires. The positive out terminal goes to the Lynx distributor. The positive in goes up to the starting battery. And then the ground wire goes to the junction stud that we just installed. And now we can put the cover back in place. And this particular cover actually has a little bit of strain relief, which holds the wires up into the terminals. The Orion XS can communicate with phones or tablets through the Victron Connect app, but this system has a Cerbo GX in it, which means that we're going to want to connect the Orion XS to the Cerbo GX with a VE Direct cable. And with the Orion wired up, we can turn power back on to the system. And programming for the new Victron Orion XS is nearly identical to the old Orion 12-12-30. And I'll put links to some guides for programming for this unit down in the video description below. And now we can turn the breaker back on to deliver power from the starter battery. And the Orion is charging in a bulk charge phase, and we can see that here in the Victron Connect app. Now what we're seeing is we're seeing an output power of 636 watts and the input of 600 and just shy of 50 watts here. And it's limiting to 50 amps on the input side, which is the max it can do here. Now we're seeing a little low on the amps on the output, and that's simply because the input voltage is a little low because the transit is currently limiting the voltage output through the CCP connection point there. And so that's why we're seeing that. As they start to drive, this should jump up to be a little bit higher as the alternator starts putting out full power. And we're going to do a little bit of testing and I'll update the pinned comment below with any results. And over here at the Touch 70 display screen that's connected to the Cerbo GX, we can see the Orion XS here in the device list. Click into that and we can see all of our information here outputs and inputs, everything like that. Now, the thing to note that as of today of making this video, we'll put the date up here, it's not being shown on the front side, and that is going to be shown on an update that is coming out probably within the next month or so from what I've heard. And you'll be able to see an alternator block on here and on the Cerbo in the Explorist Life van. We actually have that shown, but it's a beta version, and I don't like sharing beta version stuff on this channel just because not all functions and features work perfectly, and I don't want y'all to think that it does. So be on the lookout for an update on that coming out soon, and I'll put information related to that down in the pinned comment below this video. And that wraps up the installation. It was really fast. An hour? What? It was really cool. It was really easy, really quick. And that's pretty much it. The retrofit kit is really simple. There's not a whole lot of parts to it. And if you have installed the Orion 12-1230 into your own system, you know, you're totally capable of installing the retrofit kit that we've got for it. Just a couple wires, just a couple lugs, easy peasy. And it's a great upgrade. It runs a lot cooler, which we've done videos comparing the old 12-1230. We'll leave a link to that in the video description below. And that's pretty much it. Thank y'all for bringing the van out. And if you guys need your system installed and don't want to do it yourself, or this upgrade done for you, we'll put information on that down in the video description below. Anything else to add?
Nothing.
See y'all next time. We've disconnected from shore power. And now we can secure the new Orion XS to the wall. Oh, that was buying the battery. And now we can screw the Orion XS to the wall.